Sean Gaskell. I live in Asheville, North Carolina, and I'm a musician. I play the West African Kora, which is a 21-string harp. It's native to the Mandinka people who live in the countries of Gambia, Senegal, Mali, Guinea, and Guinea-Bissau, all of which are in the northwestern corner of Africa. And I had the privilege of being able to study the Kora over the course of two visits to Gambia in 2008 and 2012. Studied with two teachers while I was there for both visits. Their names were the late Malamini Jabate, who passed away in 2013, and his adopted son is Moriba Kuyate, and he still lives in Burakama in Gambia, which is the second largest city in Gambia. I found the Kora 10 years ago at a performance. It was a folk festival in Olympia, and there was an American Kora player like myself performing, and he lived in Seattle for quite some time. His name is Kane Mathis, and that night he brought down with him a djembe player and a bass guitarist, and that just listening to them for an hour was enough to change the course of my life. I really enjoyed what I heard. A couple weeks later, I talked with Kane after another one of his shows, and I figured out he was willing to teach me, and so he put me in touch with someone who had just gotten back from Gambia that month. And this person had an extra Kora, so he sold it to me, and I picked it up from the Greyhound station 3.5 weeks later, and took it up to Kane and started having lessons with him. Thank you. Especially this Kora, based on just the way that some of the strings are positioned. It sounds a little bit different than a traditional Kora. This Kora uses harp strings, and most of the traditional Koras use fishing line. That produces a different sound quality, but one of the main, I would say like the most important thing that determines the sound quality is probably down at the very bottom of the instrument, where you have this iron ring, which kind of sticks out from the bottom of the neck. And also the anchor strings, which connect to the strings that pluck. Those anchor strings are not touching the cowskin. So as a result, when you pluck the strings, the vibration just goes for a longer period. Whereas on the traditional koras, iron rings are smaller. Therefore, the anchor strings will be touching the skin. And so when you pluck each of the fish line strings and that vibration comes down and it meets the anchor string, which is touching the cow skin, it's gonna dampen out a lot faster. When you pluck a string on this Kora, it might ring out for 6 or 7 seconds, whereas when you pluck the string of a traditional Kora, it might only ring for a second or two.
Malisa Josa, Malisa. Bafuna me Malisa Josa, Malisa.
Certain things that you can do to get different sound qualities. There's a few different things that I do. You might hit two strings at a time, and you might mute one of them. You have these things where you do with the index fingers where you might like it to sound sharp, so you might try to use your fingernails a little bit. I personally just use the skin of my fingers. Like, my nails tend to get caught on the string, so I just tend to cut them back. Just things like that.
bang tira magan su sare jo tira magan ba tira magan fa tira magan su sare jo tira magan fa tira magan su sare jo tira magan.
A lot of people like to know what sort of tuning the kora is in, and it's in the same kind of scale that most Western instruments are in, because it has 7 pitches per scale, which is known as diatonic. So if you're familiar with the vocal line do re mi fa sol la ti, and then the next do is exactly 1 octave above that first do, and it doesn't matter which direction that you go. But that's the scale that the kora follows. And you can be tuned to like any key that you want to. With my kora here, I currently am using all the white keys on the piano, because you can play with other Western instruments fairly easily that way. And I just like where it fits with my vocal range. It took me a long time to get comfortable with performing in front of people. I mean, I'll even go as far as to say, I mean, when I used to get up and do presentations in front of my peers in school, whether it be elementary, even college, like I was just, got so nervous. But I think being able to talk about something that I'm so passionate about just allowed for me to become a lot more easygoing about it. And it just kind of, it felt natural after a while. And it just, I really enjoy it. Thank you.
Signor Baba, che mari, rimani vasti e che mogliano.